Here is the Makefile for the exercises in week 1. It can be found in the file assignments/week1/c/makefile. Notice that it may have changed a bit since we made this video, so don't take the details too seriously. Any part of a line after a hashtag is a comment and gets ignored. At the top of the file, a bunch of the variables are set. The variable name is to the left of the colon equal, and the value to which it is set is to the right of the colon equal. The home variable is set by default to your home directory. If you decided to install various libraries somewhere else, you may want to uncomment the first line and give the path to where you decided to do so. The line blaz_lib=etc means that the blaz library can be found in the indicated directory. What blaz stands for, you will find out later in the course. The dollar sign with the variable name in parentheses evaluates the given variable. A bunch of variables that indicate which compiler to use and what flags to pass to the compiler are set. In the section Set the range of experiments to be performed, a number of variables that indicate what problem sizes the time as part of our performance experiments are set. When we execute performance experiments, we time a range of matrix sizes. We repeat each experiment a number of times, set in variable n repeats. We then report the best time and performance from that many trials. Some may not agree with this approach, but let's not sweat that detail. N first and n last indicate the smallest and largest matrix sizes with which experiments are to be performed. N inc is the increment between matrix sizes. N last is actually adjusted slightly so that n last is an integer multiple of n inc. The reason is that for some of our experiments later in the course, the implementations only work for nicely sized matrices. The first experiment in week 1 is performed by executing makeijp. What does this do? Think of the contents of the makefile as a recipe. The make command looks for the file makefile in the current directory. It then finds the line ijp colon, which tells it that driver_ijp.x needs to be created before executing the line below. It then looks through the makefile for the line driver_ijp.x, which tells it what files need to exist before the line associated with driver_ijp.x can be executed. That then indicates that the number of object files, files ending in .o, needs to exist. It knows to create those by invoking the C compiler with the corresponding file that ends in .c. Anyway, you notice that the makefile does a whole bunch of busy work that you otherwise would have to do yourself. Some final notes. There is a tab before each executable line. There is a clean at the end of the file so that make clean erases a bunch of temporary files. This makefile is a bit of a hack. Someone who is more experienced with makefiles will probably cringe. But then it does serve our purposes, so let's not worry about that too much.